Hello everyone. Welcome to Food Tech Network. If you haven't subscribed our YouTube channel yet, then subscribe it now. And don't forget to click on the bell icon. For regular updates, visit our website www.foodtechnetwork.in and join our groups. We share jobs, webinars, quizzes, trainings, news on daily basis. We never charge any consultancy fee for jobs.
This lecture will be based on natural food colors in fruits and vegetables. Let us see what are natural food colors. Okay, so the colors which obtain from variety of sources like seeds, fruits, vegetables, algae, insects, grass, beetroot and turmeric are some of the natural sources from which colors are extracted. Okay, so these colors which are extracted from natural sources are known as natural food colors. Okay. Let us know food colors. So if the food color is red, blue and violet, that will be derived from anthocyanins and will be found in beetroots, raspberries, red cabbage. Okay. And if the color will be green, that will be derived from chlorophylls and that will be found in all leaves and stems. If the color is yellow, orange or red, that will be due to carotenoids and it will be found in apricots, carrots and tomatoes. Next is, why food color is added? What is the need of food color? Okay, so off-color foods are generally considered inferior in quality. They aren't look that much good and that much attractive like these colors. Okay, and these colors also protect the vitamins and flavors that might be affected by sunlight. Okay, these provide protection against sunlight and UV rays. It helps in preservation of food and it helps to store the food for a long time. By using colors, we can enhance the natural color of a dish and introduce decorative colors. As I have told you, it is more attractive. Okay, so colors of the food can influence the perceived flavor. Okay, so let us move next. So there are four families of plant pigments. First is chlorophyll, that is green in color. Second is carotenoids, that are yellow, red and orange in color. Third is flavonoids and fourth is betalains. Beside these, we will also learn about anthocyanins, anthoxanthins and last one is tannins. Okay. Let us learn what is chlorophyll. Chlorophyll is a green pigment that is fat soluble and it is involved in photosynthesis and are present in many plants, especially in leafy vegetables such as cabbage and lettuce. Okay, so they are related to porphyrins. Okay, so porphyrins is an important group of biological pigment which includes hemoglobin. As much as hemoglobin is important in human body, chlorophyll is that much important in a plant. Okay, so there is always some deterioration of chlorophyll on storage, whatever the processing method is. Okay, so chlorophyll is of course absorbs most of the sunlight. And since it is used as an energy source, the more wavelength it can absorb, the more energy it can use. Further, chlorophyll is classified into two parts. First, that is chlorophyll A and chlorophyll B. So, chlorophyll A absorbs the sunlight and energy to transform water and CO2 into glucose. Whereas, chlorophyll B can absorb a wider range of wavelength but cannot perform photosynthesis. Chlorophyll A is mostly found in plants, algae, cyanobacteria and converts light energy to sugar. While chlorophyll B helps in photosynthesis by absorbing light energy. Chlorophyll B is more soluble than chlorophyll A because of its carbonyl group. Here are the structures of chlorophyll A and chlorophyll B. Chlorophyll B is more soluble, okay? Moving to the next, that is carotenoids. Okay, so carotenoids are fat soluble orange yellow pigment that are present in many vegetables and fruits such as carrot, pumpkin, mango and orange. The first carotenoid isolated was from carrot and therefore was named carotene. Its concentration in vegetable is indicated by the intensity of that color. The most widely distributed carotenoids are lutein, violexanthins and neoxanthins, which found in green leaves. Okay, so carotene and xanthins also occur widely in small quantities. Some pigments predominate in certain plants like lycopene in tomato, capsanthine in red pepper and bixin in and anto. Okay, so yeah, carotene are mostly present in most green leafy vegetables along with chlorophyll, but their color is masked by the green chlorophyll. The green chlorophyll masks the color of carotene. Okay, so the fresh yellow green color of spring leaves is due to carotenoids together with small amount of chlorophyll. Okay, there is a yellow green color. Okay, green color is due to chlorophyll and yellow color is due to carotenoids. Carotenoids are extracted from ananto, saffron, paprika and tomato. Okay, and used as a natural food colorant. Extracts of carrot, butter fat and palm oil contains beta carotene, that precursors of vitamin A, and thus show vitamin A activity. Okay, in the previous slide, let us read something is important here. Carotenoids have long carbon chain with circular structure on the ends. They are quite stable molecules. Mark it, everybody. Which is why carrots stay orange when even you have boiled them for a quite long or a while. Exposure to oxygen can over time result in oxidation of molecule. Even if we boil carrots for a longer period of time, they still don't lose their colors because of the long carbon chains in carotenoids and because of their stability. Okay, there is a lot of different carotenoids. One of the most well known is beta carotenoids. Okay, beta carotenoids. Okay, so beta carotenoids are precursor of vitamin A. Okay, so which can be transformed into vitamin A as it is written here. There are a lot of more tough example. For example, lycopene, xanthophyll, lutein and zeaxanthins. Okay, moving further, flavonoids. So these are very widely distributed in plant kingdom. They are water soluble polyphenolic substances. Okay, similar in structure to anthocyanins. Okay, these and anthocyanins have similar structure. Besides, similar structure with anthocyanins, which also occur in glycosides. Okay, so what are glycosides? Glycosides are a molecule in which sugar bound to another functional group via glycosidic bond. Okay, via glycosidic bond. Okay, so yeah, what I was telling you is they are water soluble polyphenolic substances. Similar in structure with anthocyanins, which also occur as glycosides and include the subgroups of flavones, flavanols, flavanose and chalcones. Okay, so flavonoid may be the sole pigment in such vegetables such as potato, cauliflower, yellow skinned onion. Okay, the flavonoids mostly most commonly found in the nature are the flavanols, camphorol. Okay, and yeah, less common are flavonoids such as apignin, and these are some scientific names here. Yeah, it is also written here, you can write it from here or screenshot it. Flavonoids include red, purple or blue anthocyanins as well as white or pale yellow compounds such as rutin, quercetin and camphorol. Okay, so yeah, one more thing I want to tell you is flavonoids are usually more stable to heat and oxidation than the anthocyanins. Okay, we will move to anthocyanins nextly. Okay, so yeah, the flavonoid rutin. Okay, the flavonoid rutin forms dark colored complex with iron, which discolor cane food. Okay, cane food is being spoiled. Okay, so next is anthocyanins. So these are red, blue, purple and water soluble compounds. Okay, these can be red, can be blue or purple, and these are water soluble compounds occurring in the cell sap, okay, of some fruits and vegetables. For example, red cabbage, cherry, apple and yeah, colored grapes also. Okay, and it can occur in most of the flowers also. So anthocyanins are glycosides. What I have told you, what are glycosides? A molecule in which sugar bound to another functional group via glycosidic bond. Okay, which on hydrolysis yield aglycones known as anthocyanidins. Okay, which are phenyl benzopyrene derivative and sugar. A large number of anthocyanidins are known of, which six are most commonly present in food. Okay, those six are pelargonidin, cyanidin, delphinidin, fionidin, putinidin and malvidin. Okay, listen carefully what I am telling you. At low pH, the color of anthocyanins is an intense red. Okay, at low pH it is red, which changes from orange and red to blue and purple as the pH value rises. As the pH value rises, it goes to more basic, it will be basic pH, and then it will be at the base, it will be orange or red to blue. Okay, so sulfite or sulfur dioxide rapidly bleaches the color of anthocyanins. Okay, removal of sulfite by boiling and acidification result in regeneration of anthocyanins. Okay. So what's written here, the color is very sensitive to the acidity of its environment. As we move further or as we go ahead in the pH scale, it will change. Okay, this is why vegetable like red cabbage can be both bright pink, dark blue, depending on the what type of dressing, acidic or not, is on. Purple carrots are also an example of anthocyanins in vegetables. Red to purplish blue colored leaf vegetables, grains, roots, tubers are the edible vegetables that contain a high level of anthocyanins. Okay, so yeah, more things. Yeah, decolorization is not due to the sugar itself, but it is brought about its degradation product furfural and 5-hydroxymethyl furfural. Okay, so sugar influences the stability of anthocyanins. Write it. Sugar influences the stability of anthocyanins. Next is anthoxanthins. Its foremost example is cauliflower, white cauliflower. Okay, so these are the cream yellow, cream white and yellow white water soluble compounds occurring in the cell saps of some fruits and vegetables. Example, potato and cauliflower. Anthoxanthins are glycosides which on boiling with dilute acid yield one or two molecules of monosaccharides and a flavon or a flavon, okay, derivative, flavon, a flavon or a flavon derivative such as flavonol, flavonel and isoflavon. Okay, so let's read what is written here. These are not as sensitive to pH as anthocyanins. Okay, these pigments are generally whiter or in an acidic medium and yellowed in alkaline medium. Okay, these are whiter in acidic medium and yellow in basic medium or alkaline medium. These are very susceptible to color change with minerals, metal ions. Okay, we can see if we do not handle cauliflower correctly, it turns to yellowish color after some time. Okay, darkening with iron. Okay, it is the most particularly prominent in food products containing anthocyanins. These are considered to have more variety than anthocyanins, for example guaiacetin. Okay, moving further, these are betalains. Okay, so betalains are a group of red and yellow pigments found in red beet. Okay, it can be found in red beet, okay, and to some extent in cactus fruits, poke berries and a number of flowers. Okay, they resemble to the anthocyanins and flavonoids in structure, but unlike them contains nitrogen. They don't contain nitrogen and it contains nitrogen. Okay, betalains are stable in the pH range from 4 to 6, but are degraded by the thermal processing as in caning. Okay, the color in the food may not always come from plant and vegetable animal pigment, and it could be due to browning reaction. Okay, betalains have those pigments which are favorable for browning. Okay, so a number of naturally occurring substances is used for coloring food. Okay, so let us read what is written here. Common betalains are betaines, okay, and beta xanthins. We can't really digest these color as well, as which is why our urine may red after you have eaten a good portion of rich beetroot, but not after you have eaten a lot of red cabbage. Okay, and they are the most common in beets as well as a fewer types of produce. Yeah, I have told you everything earlier. Next and the last is tannins. Okay, so tannins are the colorless and yellow substances which turn brown when fruits and vegetables containing them, for example, brinjal, bottle gourd, apple, are cut and exposed to air. Okay, thus tannins are responsible for enzymatic browning and are also for astringency of foods. Okay, so tannins are a complex mixture of polymeric polyphenols. Okay. Polyphenols are the enzymes favorable for browning, as I have told in my last lecture, so tannins are a complex mixture of polymeric polyphenols, also known as tannic acid or gallantonic acid. Okay, so they are divided into two main groups, that is condensed tannins, that are catechins and related compound, and second is hydrolyzable tannins. Okay, let's read what's written here. A type of plant polyphenol are natural chemicals found in fruits that produce an astringent bitter taste. Okay, I have told you. Okay, so yeah, that's all for today.